Quran Majeed is very much meaningful book. But whenever we say Alif Lam Mim, we say Wallahu A'lamu bi Muradi, that Allah Rabbul Izzah knows about its murad perfectly. The kuffar and mushrikeen, whenever any ayah would revealed, they would talk against that verse. But whenever Alif Lam Mim was revealed, they didn't raise any question that these words are not meaningful. To understand Quran Majeed, we need to go to the pre-Arab Arabic language, the pre-history Arabic language, so that you find out whether these kind of words were existing those days or not. This is the reason when first time Huy ibn Akhtab, he was great shair of Arab, he was min al-Yahud. So when he heard Alif Lam Mim, he was running to his qawm, talking to him, do you know what Muhammad received? Alif Lam Mim. The other person said, where we will be then? Alif Lam Mim, he got a meaning. He did not explain there. They understood that and they said, okay, then you think we would be dead there? Then if he said Alif Lam Mim, they understood its meaning. So for common people, yes, some of them they said these are Asma'i Ilahiyah. Some of them said these are Asma'i Suwar. And some of them said that these are Asma, the Asma of Quran Majeed. And so many other things are there. And he was explaining one day that Alif mean 1 year, La mean 30 years, and Meem mean 40 years. So this book will take the hold of this nation for 720 years for this Makkah and Arab. And Huy ibn Akhtab again came to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he said that do you have something more about like this kind of Alif Lam Mim? He said Alif Lam Mim Saad. He started kind of making raqs over there. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Tawaseen and then Tawaseen Mim and then Kaf, Ha Ya Ayn Saad, he said that Ishtabal Amur Alayya. Now I cannot explain it. It was too much for him. But he did not say that no, it's these words are meaningless. That's the reason some of the ulama say that like Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ayn, Saad. Kaf mean Kafin, the one who is Kafi for you. Ha mean Hadin, Hadi, the one who will give you Hidayah. Ayn mean Alimin, Ya mean Hakimin, Saad mean Sadiqin. They would give them somehow the meaning. But the way of talking with these half words, yes, it was there. For example, there was a famous poet. He came in to meet to the king. King said, Wa. He smiled and said that, Enna. The king said that, okay, kick him out. No one understood, but they talked to them. And someone asked, what's Wa? Qala Wa. Qulta Enna, fama mana Wa wa Enna. So the king said, actually, when he said he was famous poet, so I reminded him that who you are actually and what's your status here in my court. So I said wa, I mean wa shu'ara'u yattabi'uhumul ghawun, that you know low kind of people following you people. What shu'ara'u yattabi'uhumul ghawun alam tara annahum fi kulli wadi yahimun. So this is your status actually, and here I need hukama. And he said inna mean innal muluka idha dakhalu qaryatan afsaduha. Inna mean, okay, the kings, when they enter a country, they describe each and everything. So I'm not like you too. So he didn't get any place and he went there. So he said, wa, and he said, inna. So these were the words actually being used there. For example, قُلْنَا لَهَا قِفِي لَنَا قَالَتْ قَاف. I said, stop, wait for me. And she said, قَاف. قَاف mean, yes, قِفْتُ لَكْ. وأنتظر. Yes, so people would use these words. And the other one, بالخير خيرات وإن شرا فا. I mean, وإن شرا فشرا. They would say, وإن شرا فا. And they say, ولا أريد شر إلا تا. ولا أريد شر إلا تا. I mean, ولا أريد شر إلا أنت شاء. So they would say, تا. So these words, Alif Lam Mim, yes, they are meaningful words. Alif Lam Mim, so this is why some of the scholars, they say that Alif Mim, Allah. Lam Mim, Jibreel. Mim mean Muhammad. So Allah revealed this book to Muhammad in Dhalikal Kitab al-Arib Fih, and whatever he revealed, there is no shak in that. Because this was the conversation with those, because in Medina, if this surah is Madani surah, so the Yahud, they said that لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ, do not listen, do not listen, do not listen. And the other thing that Alif, Laam, Meem, in 29 surahs, these words are there. In these words, 14 words are there. That Noon, Sawd, Ha, Kaf, Ya, Meem, Qaf, Alif, Ta, Ayn, Lam, Ha, Sin, Ra. These are the words that used on 29 surahs. And the other thing is that Alif, we say from here, Alif. And then Lam, we say from here. And then Meem, we say from Shafatain, Alif, Lam, Meem. And some of them, they said the asal of Huroof-e-Tahaji is these three words. Al-Halq, Al-Wasat, Al-Shafatain, Alif, Lam, Meem. Very meaningful words, but not for common people. That's why ulama kiram, they differed. They got whole different opinions about Alif, Lam, Meem. So these are actually munabbahat in Arab. They would say ya sabaha, even if this was not sabah in morning time. They would say ya sabaha, and sometimes they would say eeh, and sometimes they would say qaf, and they would understand the meaning of it. That's why, like in Surah Sad, for example, Sad. Okay, but when you recite Surah Sad, you will find the conversation of angels in Allah, mukhasma, the argumentation, and then the mukhasma of Shaitan with Allah Rabbul Izzah, the argumentation. And then the Allah Rabbul Izzah addressing to Shaitan, the argumentation. And then the argumentation of Yahud and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the argumentation. It's called khisam, khusuma, al-ikhtisam. So Swad, Swad included and encompassed each and everything over there. Subhanallah. So Huyy ibn Akhtab said that, okay, Alif, Lam, Meem mean this book. Because this Surah Baqarah and Surah Ali Imran mention the ahkamat of human society, the politicals, the constitution, the rule regulation, it's mean that this book will definitely take place in human society.